Good morning. So back to Snippet Pixie next development. Let's see where we were last session. Okay, placeholders. So yeah, so what we're doing is we're working through expanding the snippet with placeholders. So trying to expand things like a date placeholder to show a date, or snippet placeholder to expand a snippet within a snippet, and things like that. So I've decided to do date snippets first, which is one of the harder ones. It's got lots of pieces to it. And now we're starting to get into the nitty-gritty. So last session, test we had was we got to the point where we can now find the date token as such within a delimited snippet placeholder. And now we need to do something with it. So to do pass for date and expand. Okay, so this is where it gets fun. I'll bring up my previous code in Vala, because I might as well crib from it. I wrote it all. I can convert it to Go, kind of. There's a few things to need to be changed. It's not going to be the same, but the same pattern, I think. Okay, so we're basically, we've done this expand snippets bit. So, oops, that's not what I wanted. Yeah, we've done expand body. So we're kind of in this bit here now. We're going through all these little bits. If you look at here, we've split the body of the snippet up by placeholder delimiters. And in the test, we've got to the point where we've found a date, effectively. That's the substring that we've got. And that's just been used and returned. And we need to actually expand that date into something. So date is fairly complicated because it has three parts to it. Well, potentially three parts. You've got the date, placeholder, macro, whatever you want to call it, not macro, placeholder. Then you potentially have a segment which is a calculation. So the day, so it's today's day plus a day or a week or month or whatever, and then potentially a formatting as well. So they can say, but just show me the, you know, the month in words and the year or whatever you want to do, or the full time or something like that. So this is what we've got to do. So we've got to go through and find, yeah, so we're going to split it on, is that, are we doing that here? Span date placeholder. So we're getting in the body and the date. And we're going to be looking for, yeah, we're going to be looking for date or time. Now there's, in my Vala stuff, we also have the ability to change date and time to be language specific. Can't do any of that just yet, but I'll possibly will. Once we get around to actually converting this to using locales and stuff, and then doing translations. So And then what do I do? I'm taking. Doing a hash map. Okay, why am I doing that? I'm done. Ah, okay. Oh, it's just a little thing. Okay. So all I'm doing there is I'm going through and looking for these different things. If I find it, I say, okay, right, I've done it. Add it to it. And if I could find it again for some reason, I just switch, carry on. So yeah, because we only want to pass it once. But we might want to have the format to the date might include the word date for some reason. That's possible. Yeah, and this is just showing what we can do. So you should be able to do things like at date, at plus 1 m, and then percent x or whatever, although percent x is the default format. Okay. I'm kind of tempted just to like grab this and then convert it into Go. But it's gonna end up, I mean, it's gonna be relatively similar, but it's just gonna be a whole lot of red until I get it right. Which is kinda awkward. I could do it. I could try that. I haven't done that yet. It's not huge. I'm sure I could find alternates for most of these bits and bobs. Have we got? We've just got the return at the moment. Just renaming a bunch of stuff. Do that. Let's take how much we take. Take it all, I suppose, because even the macros are going to be useful. Let's see, does that actually. I've just done a vim copy paste to see that goes across. Okay. Does not go across. Apps, let's grab it. It's going to be a mess when I do this. But why not? Okay. Lots of red. Okay. So I'm going to take out. Well, actually, the first thing I need to do is take out all those semicolons. So, all the way down to there. Yep. So, let's take out there, all the way down to mark B, substitute, Semicolon, end, nothing. Okay. And now, I've got to start swapping things around. So, macros, it's going to be a slice of string. Actually, isn't there another way of doing that, isn't there? Can I not do... I don't know how slices work. Doing the make again. Let's do... And then we go over here, and we go down slices. All right, so I just put the number in and off I go. So those names. That's the way to do it. Right, okay. By putting the number in, it's an array. If I don't, it's going to be a slice because it's dynamic. So I'm almost there with what I've got in the Go stuff. Vala. Okay. So I can do... that. Why is that complaining? What's different? Oh, got to put a thing on it. Slice of strings. Good. Okay. Now, do I want to do this mappy thing? I guess I do. Well, I'll just use the same syntax as much as possible. Not syntax. Methods. So maps. Can I do a okay. So I should be able to do map string bool. Why does it not need? Oh, because it's using var there. That's fine. Okay. Do I need to use? Okay. That's fine. I think all I need to do here is Oh well, it's empty anyway. Until I stick stuff in it, so I can do a var. So it's going to be a map of string keys with strings. No. Tuples. Okay. So. Okay, so there's a couple of things I want to change before I get into this. Well, we are passing in DT, so that's good. But we've got body all over the place, and I want to do substring in here now. So, body. Whoop. Okay, I think that's got them all. And now here, we're going to do four. Don't care about the ID, do care about that. Well, the macro and the range macros. If macro name and translated, don't repeat yourselves. Yeah, okay. So if done. Get rid of that. Let's get rid of that. Actually, let's get rid of that. That. Any more ifs? Just do some basic syntax cleanup here. Very basic stuff because I want to do some search for places and these all kind of screw things up. If I leave them in. Change that while I'm here. Then what we're going to do Gonna substitute. Oh, hold on. Oh, it's done the cleanup already. That's good. What I was gonna get rid of was in Vala, the sort of default syntax is that you put a space before the parentheses after the function name. Don't know why. Guess it's trying to be kind of message passing or something. But I want to get rid of that, and just by just by saving the file there, the Go is kind of Go format has cleaned it up. I know it's Go thumped, but I don't like that. I can't say it properly. So. So, okay, so now we need to do this kind of stuff where we're fixing up this hash map check. So let's see what we've got. Let's look up, see what functions we've got and hashes. Maps. So I'm in the right place. Ah, okay. Really? Okay. So here we're going to do, I don't care about the actual contents of done, but I do care about whether it's done. That's maybe a time to rename it. I'm not using it anywhere else. So let's call it something more specific, more so. Macro. I could just do macro done. Okay, macro process, but anyway. Macro done. And then here I can do It's kind of redundant. Yeah. Macro done. Okay, so yeah, that's not even relevant at the moment, is it? I'll have to be careful here. Just so I remember. Otherwise, it's going to get messy. Right. Here we go. So, right, so what we've got. This is the only entrance in. Okay, so that's right, so now we're doing calculations. Then formatting. Okay, so here we're looking to see whether we have. Basically, down to here. Any kind of calculation, because we've got to do that, which will be interesting. So, So I need strings stuff here. So I think I'm gonna clean that out. Do it. So if strings. Dot. Now, has there a positional? Why? Index? Is it zero based? Right, index returns the index of the first instance of substring in S or minus one if substring is not present. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So if the index of going to be interesting in that substring. Maybe I should have kept it body. Right, so we want, in this case, we want a placeholder macro plus the macro plus placeholder macro again. Equals zero, we're good. Can I put a space on that to make it look better? Apparently not. Okay. Now we want the tail of it, so I'm going to do the same thing again, but substring. Right, okay, so what we're trying to do. Yeah, let's grab everything after that then. So let's see what we got. So strings dot so tail. Could do split after. Don't really want to do that though, do I? I only need. There's two things I'm taking. One thing, maybe two. So I might take. I already know that I should have some sort of calculation going on. Should have. Don't necessarily have it, but should have. And may or may not have a format after a colon. So I probably could just do a, is there a substring? No. Strings dot. What we've got. Oh. starters. Don't need the var. Do need that. Could do the split after. Looks interesting. Trim prefix. Trim prefix returns S without the provided lead in prefix string. If S doesn't start with prefix, S is returned unchanged. Okay, so can I go ahead? Take off the hello blah, and we should get gophers. Howdy. That's not a good code example, because surely that would actually print out. Oh, yeah, okay. Yes, manipulating the same thing. Okay, so that's fine. So what we can do here is we can take the substring. And take off that. And then here, want to take so strings dot I can split it, I guess. What do here is I was going to do a trim prefix there. What I'll do is I'll do parts equals strings dot split see what that says. But want to do split after n and do one. Right, split after. Split after slices s into all substrings after each instance of separator and returns a slice of those substrings. If s does not contain separator, separator is not empty. Split after returns a slice of length 1 whose only element is s. If separator is empty, split after splits after each union sequence. Okay. Both s and s separator split after returns a slice. Okay. A, B, C, dink. Oh, okay. That's not what I want. Because I don't want the separator included. You really want one split, so split n. What does that do then? Slice s into substrings separated by a separator and returns a slice of the substrings between those separators. So really, Okay, so I have to use 2 and then pluck out. The rest. Okay, I guess. So, on the substring, separator. So carry on, 2 slices, and then, in theory, so now we're working with slices, go back, I should be able to just take this kind of syntax. So let's say 1, 2, 3, 4. So that should print out 2, 3, 5, 7. What is run? Ah, no, zero based. So if I do 0 there. Okay. What if I do... Right, so if I want the tail. Is it that? What happens if you do that? Just get 2? Yeah, okay. But that's the same as just doing that. Oh. Right, now you have to do it. You have to give it a position. Okay. But, right, so what I want, if I do that, I get everything. But if I do that, I get the tail. If there is one. So that's interesting actually, because if I do that, no, it's indexed on 1. So 1. Oh, okay. One and everything else, right. Okay. So that's the tail. From index 1, onwards. Can I use that? Is that going to be useful here? So if I split it into parts and then I take... I can do different things here. So this is the issue. I need to be very careful about what I take. What happens? What I can do, I guess, is check. Because in the Vala code, being a bit Not being quite as careful as I should, I think. Actually. I don't need to split. I don't need to split at all. We've really seen what we can do. We can do a trim prefix. Oh, let's do it all in one. So trim the prefix. Of the substring, that's the. Oh no, sorry, not trim prefix. Want. No, I do have to split. What's fields do? Okay, I'm going to just split in. Do the substring and separator is that, and we want two parts. Then we can do calc should be. So, see, that's where I'm going to come unstuck here. If so the problem I've got is what if we don't have a colon? Am I really going to have to wrap this in ifs and stuff? Okay. Let's do, well, I guess we can see what happens and then deal with it. So I'm gonna take, I'm gonna assume always going to have something. So I'll take. Oops. Part zero. What was the thing I could do there? If I wanted just two. Have to do no. Found and okay. Right, okay. Right, it's the exclusion here. Okay. So take everything up to zero effectively, up to including zero. Then here, parts we want. To include one, anything else. That's right, isn't it? So this should return three and everything else. Yeah, okay. Because it's include, exclude. Okay. Now I'm not sure what's going to happen here. We have some weird formats, so we'll see what goes on. Maybe fix date placeholder format. Okay, what on earth was that? We should put a little bit more comments on this. So strip the lead index from the format string. Don't need to do that. The format string length was 0. Macro equals date or macro. Oh, okay. Right, that is relatively important. do need to do it twice as well. There. And if we have a format, yeah, I think we'll take that. Haven't got this stuff though yet. We shouldn't need to do that if we're going through. I guess we do. I might just do quick and dirty here on that one. So, yeah, I can fix this up later. So, if round our length, which I should trim that. Good point. That's a bit of a pain, isn't it? I don't really want to do that because I don't want slices. I just want two strings. So I'm going to have to join them or. I guess I could just do an index. I wonder. Do replace. There's no like substring. I'm just trying to do it without having to muck about with slices because it gets a bit painful. I know they can be mung together and stuff, but just do that. Guess I could just do that. It'd be nice if I just did. Take the index. And their place. So many different ways to do this, but maybe. Maybe I should just do that. Does that need the same? Yes. Here, can I do Is there such a thing as a ternary? Apparently not. What's going on? Not have ternary thingies. Okay. The answer is no. It's too nested here, I think. Because I might do... later on, I'll switch a bit for Lang stuff. Okay. So maybe it's a little bit easier to read. So what we're going to get in is a proper time, which should be now. Not sure we need to do this. Let me just do that. Okay, so that's an interesting one, that one, split set. Don't know whether we've got that kind of thing in Go, so got there. So what we're doing, so if that's interesting. I'm gonna need to look up split set, I think. Can't remember what I'm doing there. It looks like based on that. Again, an iterable. I'm going over it, okay. So we're taking the first part. Grabbing the integer. Launching length. All right, okay. So plucking out bits. Kind of have to be careful about how we do the calculation as well. Don't really want to do it like this. That's a bit. Bit prone to error. Cool, got Tommy. That was my Tommy. How are we gonna do this? Could just walk it. So the format. The format I have is that it's like a positive or negative number, and then unit. So it's like, so that's like plus 3 hours in that case. So this one you got 2 weeks. Not sure whether that current method is great. Could. Well, for starters, I don't think I've got something like split set. So what have we got there? I do have a split. We've got index with a function. Fields, but that's not going to work, I guess. Okay, that could work. Okay. So I could use that and say, okay, if the rune is one of the month, day, year, blah, 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 return true. And then we would get a slice. With things like plus one, two, three, but what's that? Field splits string returns an array, so that's if full code points and this, that's why. We'll see, it makes no guarantees about the order in which it calls. It assumes that if always returns the same value for a given C. The one slight sticking point there is not guaranteeing the order. Because well, I guess if we're careful, that probably isn't an issue on the date. So in the date, if you do like plus 1 year, minus 1 day and all that kind of stuff. If you're using a pure like UTC date at the back end and then convert to local. Might be okay. Gets a bit tricky if you start mixing up those two things. But that's still not great. To do that. I gotta go anyway. So index function, I presume, is the same. Okay. I could just loop over. Just walk it and then well, no, I could just loop over the items that we want to do. Mind you, that's what split set does. But now I could just do a slice. Take an index. could be a lot easier. If I could do split after, where the separator. It's a whole list. And then I'd have things like plus one y and all that kind of stuff. We just walk that, do it, done. That'd be really handy. I need to think about that because the way I'm doing it at the moment is a little bit messy. I might just have to do it. If I just make that a slice. And just walk it. Pluck out bits from the index. Although, index func could be useful. Oh, index any. Oh, okay. I could do that. I could do that, mutate it, carry on, and keep plucking out the first index. Yeah, okay. Let's leave myself a little note. So, oops. What did I do there? Nothing. Yeah, index any, I think, to do. Use strings dot index any to find the first quote token, should we? Yeah. Process head. Then index any. I think that'll do the job. Right, I gotta go. So thanks for watching. Until next time, take care. Bye.